All right, now what I'm going to do is set our navigational alignment with the GPS. So I'll come over to the, this is our FMC, flight management computer. I want to clear out that error. We'll go to position initiation. All right, so that's where those boxes indicate missing data that needs to be input. Now we'll come over here to go to the previous page. This is our navigational system. So we got a GPS left, GPS right, and then our FMC left, FMC right. So we're gonna take one of the GPS datas. When I push that button, it automatically moves the data down to the bottom of the page. And I'll go back to the previous page. And then I'll just select over here. It shows that this data is down here. And when I push the button over here, these are called line select keys. When I push the line select key, it will automatically put whatever data is on the bottom in the clipboard, basically, into that spot. And now our alignment message is gone. And we're all aligned. We've got all of our data. Shows where we're at in the world. This is our overhead panel. This is our air conditioning panel. That equipment cooling, recirculation fans, trim valves. These are temperature selectors where we actually, you can select your temperature, upper, colder and hotter. I've got it set a little bit cool right now to bring down the temperature. Our passenger likes it cooler. These are the pack valves that turn the packs on and off. These are the trim air valves. It helps regulate the temperature. These are our bleed valves, isolation valves. When we're in flight, you feed from the right system, from the right engine to the right system, from the left engine to the left system. If there becomes a problem and we lose power from one engine, say one engine doesn't, or you know, quits for some reason, then we can open these isolation valves. Actually, in this position, will automatically open if it senses that there's a loss of supply from here. And then this will feed them all. It's our pressurization panel. It's in auto now. The outflow valves are in auto. You can manually change your landing altitude here if you needed to for some reason. This is windshield wipers. I'm not going to turn them on right now because the window is full of dirt and it might scuff it up a little bit. I'll have to clean those here in a minute. These are runway lights, beacon. It flashes on the bottom and the top. This is our nav lights for the wing tips, the red and the green, and the white on the trailing edge of the wing and the tail white light. So logo lights that show up from the top of the horizontal to up the tail. They show up the vertical part. These are wing lights. These are your runway turn-off lights. Those are the big lights on the wing roots. These are the lights on the nose. These are strobe lights for visibility. We fly, let's see, with those on all the time. This is the landing lights, the big lights on the wings again. This is a light adjustment, bright and dim. This is adjustment overhead circuit breakers. This is adjustment for the dome lights. This is a storm light, which adds additional lighting to the cockpit. And this is your master lighting control, which lights. It controls all the bright and dim lights at one time. It's your anti-ice panel. We operate with everything in auto. So you get your engines and your wings. This microphone is for recording the cockpit voice for emergencies and things like that. That's where your voice would be recorded. And then it's on a looping deal, so it records the last, I don't know, 30, 40 minutes or an hour or something like that. Passenger signs, put them in auto, and then at certain configurations of the airplane, like with the flaps down and the landing gear down, it will automatically turn on the sit down and no smoking signs. Let's see, this is our fuel panel. Right now we're feeding from this pump, which is automatically connected to the APU. And let's see, I'm going to display the fuel feed. So it's feeding from the forward left pump up to the APU. Okay. And then when we don't have any fuel in the center right at this moment, but normally that would feed first and then these would feed next. So when we get ready to take off, we'll turn on these pumps, and if we have fuel in the center, we'll turn on those pumps. And these have higher outlet pressure, so they will feed first. So they will override these pumps and close the check valve until these are empty. This is a fuel jettison, where we showed that on the wing. You lift these protected valves, and then you can dump fuel out. This is the engine starts, so when they actually get ready to start, they'll turn that over to start. If we get into storms or bad, really heavy rains, that goes over to continuous, so we have continuous ignition sparking in there, so we don't have a flame out. This is our fire panel for the cargo and the APU. You select where you want to hit it, and you lift that up and pow, blast it. This is our flight information data. Shows different kinds of briefings that you can do. Time to destination, stuff like that. That's where we'll select a briefing. Takeoff briefing, then you push the button and it plays the takeoff, sit down, pre-landing, turbulence, over water. And on our airplane, we have a prayer. And return. This is our unique to us. We've got an interior door system monitor. We've got a passenger and galley entertainment system. We have a medical room, passenger oxygen. There's more passenger oxygen. Service interphone. It's our emergency lights. Window heats for the cockpit windows. Ram air turbine. You lift that and push the button and out the side. On the right behind the wing pops down a little windmill that provides hydraulic power and electric power. This is our hydraulic control panel. We have on the engine, we have an electric one, and then we have an engine driven mechanically one. On that, and here we got two air pumps for the center hydraulic system. These are driven by bleed air pressure. Two electric pumps. A electric pump on the left engine and an air-driven pump on the left engine, or engine-driven pump, driven by the gears. All right, so that, we have a lot of redundancy there. All right, which way were I going? Oh, I was going down. I already did that. And we did that. This is unique to our plane as well. This is our cabin fire detection system. We've got 14 zones. So if we have a problem, smoke detection, that tells us where it is. We can go back and investigate. This is our ATAROOS. This is our navigation system. Air data inertial reference unit. It's like our GPSs and all that stuff. Our primary flight computers, thrust asymmet computer. Can't pronounce that. This is our electrical panel, the main battery switch, APU generator. This is the APU selector on or off. These are the bus tie switches, so you can select between where you're feeding from. Right now we're feeding from the APU. When the engines start, they will feed and the APU will go offline. We have two external power plugs, and so these are both of those. If we use external power, we'll select either one of those. This is our main bus, left transfer bus, right transfer bus, the backup battery or backup generator system, and then the left windshield wiper.